Hello, everyone. This is Tom Fox. I would like to welcome you to the Sunday Book Review. The Sunday Book Review is the series where I discuss books which impact the compliance practitioner, the legal professional, and the business professional. I hope you will enjoy this episode. Sunday Book Review for January 17, 2020, the MLK edition. Today we celebrate Martin Luther King by taking a look at four books that I think are essential for reading, for understanding Dr. King, his times in the civil rights movement in the 1960s. We began with the three-part trilogy by Taylor Branch, Parting the Waters, America in the King Years, 1954 to 1963. This is the essential American volume on King, I believe, or series of volumes, hailed as the most masterful story ever told of the American civil rights movement. Parting the Waters is destined to endure for generations. Moving from the fiery baptism of MLK to the corridors of Camelot, where the Kennedy brothers weighed demands for justice against the deceptions of J. Edgar Hoover, here is the vivid tapestry of America torn and finally transformed from a revolutionary struggle unequaled since the Civil War, particularly appropriate in 2020 or 2021, I would say. Taylor Branch provides an unsurpassed portrait of King's rise to greatness and illuminates the stunning courage and private conflict, the deals, the maneuvers, the betrayals, and rivalries that determine history behind closed doors, boycotts, sit-ins, freedom rides, and through siege and murder. Epic in scope and impact, Branch's chronicle definitely captures one of the nation's most critical passages. Next up, Judgment Days by Nick Kotz. The Pulitzer Prize-winning journalist offers the first thorough account of the complex working relationship between LBJ and MLK, tracing the leader's past from Johnson's ascendancy to the presidency in 1963 all the way to King's assassination in 68. Kotz describes how they formed a wary alliance that became instrumental in producing some of the most substantial civil rights legislation in American history. Drawing on a wealth of newly available sources, Johnson's taped phone conversations, voluminous FBI wiretap logs, and secret communications between the FBI and the president, Kotz examines forces that drew the charismatic men together and those that eventually drove them apart. Kotz's focus and incisive examination significantly enriches our understanding of both men. Next up, the speech. Of course, this refers to the 1963 I Have a Dream speech. The day before, rather by Gary Young, the day before he'd ask his aides for advice on the speech, and they said, don't use the lines about I have a dream. It's trite and cliche, yet some 60 years later, it is viewed as one of the greatest speeches in American history. Countless speeches have delivered on civil rights, and indeed many other besides MLK's were delivered at the March on Washington. What makes this one so special? And what makes it the one we remember? Young examines the speech so timely and so timeless. Few at the time could have imagined the world he was evoking, but its achieved aims, and all believed it was possible. 60 years later, it is clear that eliminating segregation, not racism, but formal codified explicit discrimination, the civil rights movement needs to deliver on this last moral victory for America. And we end with, of course, the assassination. Killing the Dream by Gerald Posner. In the three decades, or rather the multiple decades, since he was assassinated, scores of books have looked at this. Now, based on explosive new evidence, confidential files, and previously undisclosed material, best-selling author Gerald Posner finally resolves the simple truth of the last great political murder mystery of the 60s, proving that Ray acted alone. Beginning with a straightforward narrative of events during and after the shooting, Posner untangles the leading puzzles. This month on The Compliance Life, I'm continuing my conversation with Gwen Hassan, Managing Director for Compliance at CNH Industrial. It's a fascinating exploration of Gwen's travel to and work in compliance. This continues this most popular series on the Compliance Podcast Network. Check it out. I know you'll enjoy it. The Compliance Life, this month featuring Gwen Hassan. Thank you for joining me again on this edition of the Sunday Book Review, and I hope you'll join me again next Sunday.